Five Cal Poly football players accused of an attempted armed robbery entered their pleas in court today. News Channel 3 reporter Natalie Tavidian is live in San Luis Obispo tonight, and you have a reaction to what happened today.
CJ, earlier in court this morning, all five of the players entered a plea of not guilty. I spoke with the attorney representing Christian Ivory, the former star running back, and he tells me that his client is more concerned about getting back in the classroom than he is about getting back on the team. Not only was this going to be Christian Ivory's senior year at Cal Poly, he was one of the school's best offensive weapons. The star running back coming off a season where he scored 7 touchdowns. Now he's cut from the team and kicked out of school. His attorney says he intends on beating charges of attempted robbery with only one goal.
Primary goal and concern and focus is on school. Christian wants to get back into the classroom when school starts next week. Football is a distant secondary concern. He's concerned about this case and the charges against him, and he's concerned about his school and his education.
Today in court, his Los Angeles-based attorney filed a demur to have one of the counts of conspiracy against him dismissed. The judge refused. Police say they can prove Ivory was involved in the robbery because his wallet and cell phone were found in the rented car used in the crime. Prosecutors say that car was driven by Cortland Fort.
He knew none of these other defendants other than on the football field.
His attorney says Fort was actually doing a good deed, shuttling the other football players to a party as a designated driver.
We have found a percipient witness. That's a person who was there at the scene of a different party, overhearing one or more of the co-defendants asking my client to drive a vehicle because he was a sober driver.
And police do say that the gunman in this robbery is Cameron Akins. The accused is Cameron Akins, but although he's the only one accused of having a gun, all five of the men do face felony charges. They will be back in court on October 1st. In the meantime, school starts back up on Monday. You can see students moving in behind me here in the Cal Poly campus. This is welcome week for them, but the attorneys I spoke with today say it's not clear whether their kids will be back on campus on Monday. Live at Cal Poly, Natalie Tavidian, News Channel 3.
All right, thank you.